Hi, I'm Jonathan. I am a gym member at Sulcana Fitness, and I've been going there for about 3 years. I really love it, and I'm going there with my partner, and it's been a good time. So,
Shameless plug. Shameless plug. Thank you. Okay, cool. Well, I'm about to improvise an entire show based on your story. So I can't wait to hear what it is.
great. Do you just want me to jump in?
Yeah.
Okay. So I'm going to preface my story just by saying that before I started middle school, my parents had sat me down and talked with me about how kids in middle school don't wear sweatpants. And so I had it in my head that I needed to change my wardrobe and kind of become an adult a little bit. So when I was 13 years old, kind of in the middle of middle school, I was still really into a lot of things, and one of them was X-Men. I loved X-Men just so much. And I got into reading like X-Men fan fiction, looking at X-Men theories and all these different characters. But I just felt that, maybe it was too late to be interested in X-Men. Now I'm a 13-year-old, I need to grow up and all of that. So I was looking at a bunch of X-Men on my computer, and my mom was coming downstairs with like a basket of laundry. And I just remember I covered the computer with my hands, and I said, "Mom, mom, don't look at the computer right now." And she says, "John, I need to see the computer." And I'm like, "Mom, please don't look at the computer." And she says, "John, I really need to see it." And so I opened my hands, and she was probably expecting something different than that.
Yeah.
But my expectation as a child was, I'm going to get a lecture on how I need to grow up, how I need to be an adult, how kids don't do this anymore, people my age don't do this. And I think she was caught aback a bit, and she was like, "It's okay that you like X-Men. That's honestly fine. That's an okay thing." And I was like, "Oh, okay, well then that's great." So then I just never really lost it. And I still like X-Men even to this day. Has so much
I feel
depth.
like plenty of adults love X-Men.
Yes. But I grew up watching X-Men animated series. It's like a 90s cartoon, and I still liked it, like even in middle school. So yeah.
Awesome. I love that story. Okay, I have some ideas. I'm super excited to just get started.
Stepped into a brand new school, they said, "Do whatever you can. It's time to grow up, little boy. You're not a boy. Oh, let go of your sweatpants and move on to jeans. Let go of your cartoon fantasies and all your comic books. Life is not as sweet and magical as it seems." Oh, they said, grow up and move on. But I'm having a harder time than anybody else. They said, "It's time to change, it's time to change, it's time." But I'm having a hard time moving on from who I was before. I guess I can try, I'll put in some effort. But who am I if I don't be myself? All I know is I don't want to be picked on anymore. So I guess I'll hang up my old stuff on a shelf.
I guess
said, no more, Jonathan. No more acting like a little kid, because now you're going to be in sixth grade. And kids in sixth grade need to be grown. They need to know about the world. They need to know what's out there, because pretty soon you're going to be big enough to work. And then you'll be big enough to go to college. And then you'll be big enough to have a family and big enough to forget about all the stuff you like now. I guess. Adults are so stupid.
John, what are you up to, son?
Oh, nothing, Mom.
Well, let me see. What's in there?
Oh, no, it's nothing. I was just looking up, porn.
Let me just take a look, okay? I'm not going to get in your face about it, but let me take a look.
Really? Okay. Here.
The X-Men. John, what have we told you about this kid stuff? I'm disappointed, I have to say.
Okay, Mom. You're right.
Like I said, Johnny boy, this stuff might be okay for babies, but you're going to be in sixth grade now. So you need to let it go. It's just a fantasy world. It's not real. Time to grow up, honey.
I just wanted to look one more time, just to see if everything was the same. I guess I'll go to bed now.
Good night, dear. I love you. My big man, my adult growing up man who's no longer a boy. Now get some sleep.
Night, Mama. It can't hurt just to save one picture. Just one picture. Let's see. Just one little picture. It's gonna be fine. It's just for my own self. I'm just gonna save it. Even though I know none of this is real and I need to let it go, I'm just gonna save this one picture just in case.
Come on, puppy. Where am I? Who are you? Where did you come from? A boy? Who am I? Well, I'm Stick. You don't know me? I'm Stick. I'm the X-Men, Stick. Stick? I've never heard of a Stick. I mean, I know all the other ones. Storm, Wolverine, Slasher, big, strong guy, the Hulk, maybe? Rock Man? Holy Bucket Boy? I know all those guys, the wheels for legs, but I've never heard of Stick. You don't know Stick? Well, you have a picture of me right here. I'll tell you who I am. You in the future when you're wondering which of the X-Men are there that are often underappreciated, I'm one of them. Oh, I see. So you're one of the X-Men that no one ever wrote anything about. That kind of feels like me. Yeah. I'm someone who's easily forgotten.
Oh, easily forgotten. I can relate to that. I'm oft forgotten, as I mentioned in my song.
What do you do about it? I mean, it kind of stinks, you know? You gotta pretend like you're somebody else than who you really are, just so you can be noticed.
Oh, trust me, I've tried that. I've pretended to be every other X-Men that I could possibly be. I thought it would work, but I was always found out because I couldn't actually do any of their powers.
Yeah, that makes sense. I tried out for a sport once, but it was pretty obvious I don't play sports. I'm meant for a different life, I guess.
Huh. So you're in school then, I take it. You know, I can help you get noticed. And then maybe thereby I would get noticed. If you were noticed, then the X-Men would have to take notice of me.
Well, what do you propose?
Well, it's rather simple, I suppose. You could use my powers. I could be with you at school, and you could use my powers, and you would impress everybody, and they would know that you were a big man.
Okay, that sounds awesome. Let's do it.
Well, this is my school. I'm glad you could fit in my backpack. I think that's a pretty cool skill. Wow, a real school with real kids. I've never seen anything like this before. Well, we were always in the academy, so it's a little bit different. This is the hallway I usually go down. Not a lot of kids are nice to me in this hallway. Well, they ignore me, or they push me, or they shove me, or they call me names, pretty much. What do you mean they make fun of you? Well, we could teach them a lesson or two.
Well, the academy sounds interesting. I wish I could go to a place like the academy. Oh, right there. That's the kid in my school that bullies me the most. His name is Bill.
Oh, I see him. Bill, huh? Well, let me out of here. I can help. Let's prove what a man you really are. What's up, you little bitch? You look like a dweeb-ass mother bitcher today. Fucking idiot. Where's your lunch money, dweebus?
I'm not a dweebus. And my lunch money's... it's right here. Here.
You little bitch. I need you to give me your money like that. Easy peasy, lemon freaking squeezy. Little bitch, huh? Little bitch, huh?
Stay in there! Not right now! Not right now!
What the fuck is that in your backpack, dude? You carrying around some hair or what?
You better watch who you're calling a bitch or a dweeb.
Now, Bill.
Oh no. Oh no. Stick. You turned him into a stick.
Of course I did. It's what I do. I'm Stick, like I explained. People don't really see my power with a lot of having a lot of value, but it does, as you can see, because now your bully is Stick.
But is he gonna be like this forever?
Well, yeah, that's kind of the whole point, is that he's a stick now. So he's off your back and you can let it go.
Let's get on a good real time. Let's turn some boys into some firewood kindling. Let's turn around and say zapty bapty boo, because Stick is coming for you. Well, go around to school and pick out boys. They've all done wrong to him, I know it's true. Well, don't you worry, little Jonathan, I'm here to turn all these bad boys into sticks for you. I may have been underappreciated. Woo! No one has noticed me in the past. It's true, but now I'm here in the regular middle school world. I will show you. Here I come. Here comes a stick. Here I come. Rickety tickety tick. Here I come. Don't forget my name. Here I come to turn you into a redwood flame. Vendettas pointing at you with my fingers out.
Oh no. Stick, what did you do to my school?
I did exactly what you asked for. I helped you become a man and teach everybody a lesson about picking on a boy. But well, we could go home and teach your parents a lesson too. What do you say?
Stick, no! That's not what I wanted at all. I didn't want my entire school to be turned into sticks.
Then why'd you save my picture, little boy, if you didn't want to interact with Stick, the best X-Men that there is?
I was just trying to cling on to my youth a little bit longer. I don't know, my mom said I shouldn't look at that stuff and I just wanted to see, I don't know. Just take it back, will you, Stick, please?
Take it back? I can't just take back my powers. My fingers emanate bark. That's what happens. Everything I touch turns into Stick.
That's why I'm called Stick. I'm feeling crappy that you're not appreciating me.
I did all of that just for you.
Be nicer or I'll turn you into a stick next.
You are the one who everyone has forgotten in the past. You are the one that everyone has simply walked past. You're the one they've left behind, and it's not because you're forgotten. You're the one who will be left behind simply because you're downtrodden. Oh, they left you behind because you have no real skills. You're the one I will kill. Now I see it's true. I was always special. What makes you think that, you tiny little devil? Because it doesn't take powers to realize you have some. Well, I bet you couldn't make a stick come right out of your thumb. But that doesn't matter. I'm in charge of my own destiny. Then why, little boy, were you saving pictures of me? I'm all grown up. I decided to be so. Well, I will tell you. hurt so. I'll keep everything that I wanna keep when I get bigger. And I'm in control of you. You're just a figment of my imagination. I will squish you so small by just saying you have no power. What are you doing? How are you doing this? Please, please. Goodbye. Yeah.
That's right. If I just believe that I have more power than you, I do. Oh, I'm shrinking. What are you doing to me? You can't just stop believing in me. I'm real. Don't forget, stay. Never forget, stay. Stick? If you're a stick, does that mean everybody else is? Oh! What the hell was that? Did you do something to me, Dweebus? Actually, yeah, Bill, I did. I told you no, you can't have my lunch money. Because I'm a sixth grader now, and you can't just take what you want from me just because I look small. And look young. Okay, man. Okay. I'm sorry. Whatever you did to me, just don't do it again. Yeah, I won't. Just... Okay, man. I'm going. Wow. The whole school is back to normal. Just like that. Everything's just back to normal, I guess. Except me. Not that anyone knows. It's just little old me. Ah, such a long and crazy day. I mean, I feel like all I've ever wanted was to meet an X-Men, you know? And to be able to talk to one, and then I finally did, and she wasn't very nice, and she kind of made my life a lot harder. Until I believed I actually had some power over her, and then everything went back to normal. I guess it's time to say goodbye to my X-Men.
It's goodbye, Stick.
Jonathan, I was just checking on you before bed. You know, I was thinking maybe you could take some of these childish posters down now that you've grown up enough and you're done with your childish ways. You know, finally, I had a call from school today, something about the whole school turning into a forest. Do you know anything about that? Oh, no. It's just a rumor. You know what, Mom? I'm not gonna take my posters down. I'm not ready to. I wanna keep them up. And I'll decide when they come down. Because I'm grown up now, and what that means for me is I get to choose what I like, and I get to choose what I believe in. And I get to choose what direction my life goes, and nobody can choose it for me. Not even Stick. Who, darling? Stick? All right, I understand. It's your room. You do what you want with it. You know, it's not really about that anyway. It's not about just the childish things. It's just your father and I want to prepare you for what is a very difficult and harsh world because we love you. But it seems like you know better than anyone. I love you, honey. Now, good night. Get some sleep.
Or don't, whatever.